And the family of a man shot and killed in Milwaukee is responding to the gunman's claim of self-defense. Theodore Edgecombe is accused of killing Jason Clearman last year. Now, Stephanie Haynes shares why the Clearman's family disagrees with Edgecombe's defense.
Theodore Edgecombe was back in court Tuesday for his last hearing before trial. He is charged with shooting and killing immigration attorney Jason Clearman. Prosecutors believe it happened on the Holton Street Bridge last year after an argument on the road. Defense attorneys say Edgecombe acted in self-defense. They point to this surveillance video, saying it shows Clearman follow and approach Edgecombe moments before he fires.
We hope everyone continues to, keep a open mind and not try the case in the media and just wait till the facts come about.
On Tuesday, the Clearman family responded, writing in a statement, quote, "Mr. Edgecombe did not act in self-defense, and this is not a close case." It goes on to say, "Mr. Edgecombe acted violently first, reaching into the Clearman car and striking Jason Clearman in the face and injuring him." At the time of the shooting, Edgecombe was out on bond and was not allowed to have a gun. He was arrested about 6 months later in Kentucky. The defense team fought to limit what the jury could hear.
The state's attempt here is to bootstrap this bail jumping charge to prejudice the jury by confusing them to try to continue a narrative that somehow Mr. Edgecombe would not be privileged to exercise self-defense because he would perhaps have an order that would deny him the right to have a firearm in the first place.
The Clearman family writes, "This is a clear case of Theodore Edgecombe's one-sided violence, armed murder, and flight from justice, one that a controversial verdict in another county does not justify." Jury selection begins on January 3rd, and the judge says he will call a slightly bigger jury pool than normal. In Milwaukee, Stephanie Haynes, TMJ4 News.